Attention. If you owe back taxes to the IRS, watch this urgent message. The IRS is cracking down by hiring 87,000 new agents to garnish your paycheck and put liens on homes and businesses. They can even seize your bank account. The IRS calls it enforced compliance, and now they have the manpower to get you. Penalties and interest on unpaid taxes compound daily. So call One-Stop Tax Relief Shop and get the IRS off your back. They're experts in the Fresh Start Initiative, one of the biggest breaks the IRS has ever offered. And no other tax shop gets you more or faster approvals. One-Stop Tax Relief has resolved thousands of cases since 2014 and saved clients millions of dollars. Call now for a free consultation. Connect with tax professionals who get the IRS off your back.
Call 800-605-0688. 800-605-0688.
One-Stop Tax Relief Shop. 80% of falls in the home occur in the bathroom. Don't put yourself or a loved one at risk. There's a safe bathing system for everyone's budget.
Enjoy a bathing experience that combines safety, comfort, and excellence. If assisted living is not for you, a BCI walk-in tub may well be the answer, giving you the safety and freedom to live independently. A BCI walk-in tub is the most affordable and comfortable walk-in tub in the market today. With our dual drain technology, your tub will drain quickly, and for those that still like the feature of a shower, our two-way bliss gives you both a handheld and overhead shower head. We offer the best financing in the industry with payments as low as $99 per month or no interest, no payments for 18 months with approved credit. For comfort, safety, price, and selection, it's got to be BCI Walk-In Tub. Be one of the first 50 callers and save $1,500.
Call 800-354-4377, 800-354-4377 for a free no-obligation in-home consultation.
The Turnpike Sports Book Report is brought to you by BorgataSports.com. Your favorite casino is now your favorite sports book, available anywhere in New Jersey, BorgataSports.com. Sign up at BorgataSports.com using our promo code PIKE, that's P-I-K-E. Make your first wager of $20 or more and you'll get $100 in free bets. That's $100 in free bets when your first wager on Borgata Sports is $20 or more. Get into the action with BorgataSports.com. Must be 21 years or older and in New Jersey to place a bet. Terms and conditions apply. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-GAMBLER.
And welcome to this week's edition of the Turnpike Sports Book Report. I'm Doug Weischadle here with Dave Weischadle. We're here to give you a whip-around look at some of the news coming out of the sports betting industry over the past week. This week, in our deal segment, we've got some geolocated transactions to talk about for the first weekend of the Ohio sports betting launch.
Geolocation, huh?
Yes, yes. Always a
I love that
mainstay
technology.
Of the industry.
There's this whole thing about geolocation. They can pick out people regardless of where they are. I think they did one time, they looked at how many people bet in a certain stadium, which is always interesting.
And we've got some benchmarks to hit for Nevada, Virginia, and Colorado. Deals, we've got deals involving wager score, IGT. We've even got a couple acquisition notes to hit upon for this week's deal segment. Industry updates, we've got news coming out of Ohio, including a very unique sports betting licensee in that state.
Oh, okay.
Massachusetts has some news coming out from their application processes involving Fanatics. And we've also got a new president in one of the Atlantic City casinos.
Yes.
And then we're going to finish up with the legislative roundup. We've got legislative news coming out of Colorado, Massachusetts, Ohio. And if we have time, we've got New York and Oklahoma news to talk about as well.
Okay.
So let's start off with the numbers. As I said at the top of the show, we have some geolocated transaction numbers for the Ohio sports betting industry launch, which happened over the holiday weekend, January 1st and 2nd to be exact. Mm-hmm. GeoComply reported that there were, and let me get this number right because this is a very interesting number, 11.3 million geolocated transactions in the state over the weekend.
Very impressive.
It was number one for that weekend. It beat New York.
Yeah.
Not a lot of states can say they beat New York.
Yeah.
But,
yeah.
Good for Ohio. Good for
Ohio.
They actually beat a lot of people.
Well, if you beat New York, you know you're the top market.
Well, here's the list. We have Ohio first, 11.3 million. Then we have New York coming in second with 9.3 million transactions mm-hmm. over the weekend. And you got to remember, Ohio only did 2 days of the weekend.
Yeah, yeah.
They didn't do Friday and Saturday.
Yeah, yeah.
So very interesting the way Ohio jumped out to the lead like that. Pennsylvania came in third with 8.2 million transactions. And New Jersey rounded out the top four. First time I've seen New Jersey at the bottom of a list, yeah, to be honest yeah. with you. 6.7 million transactions for the weekend.
Okay.
This is not to say this is Ohio's launch compared to New York's launch, by the way. That was a lot of confusion. A lot of people seem to be confused about that. It was Ohio's launch versus the same weekend for the New York state.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
it wasn't launch comparisons.
Yeah.
I'd actually like
still
to see
very the, impressive, though.
I actually
very,
want to see what impressive. The launch comparisons were
sure,
between
sure.
the two states. But in terms of cities, Cincinnati was the top city.
Okay.
They had 1.898 million geolocated transactions. So about just under 1.9 million mm-hmm. transactions. Ohio's largest city came in second, Columbus.
Okay.
Columbus had 1.03 million transactions. Then Cleveland and Toledo came in third and fourth. Toledo rounded out with 619,000 geolocated transactions for the first weekend.
I'm shocked that Cleveland didn't beat Columbus. So it's very interesting.
I still, and this is my geography problem. I still don't think of Columbus as the largest city. When I think of Ohio,
well, it's
I really,
the capital, isn't it?
Yeah,
I have to remember my capitals. Yeah, Columbus yeah. is the capital.
I always think Cincinnati and Cleveland are the largest.
Yeah,
I never really think of Columbus as the largest city, and that's on me. That's not on anything else. So, but again, some really interesting numbers.
Great numbers. They're the fantastic numbers.
Here's an interesting one. In the first hour of the new year, GeoComply recorded 234,000
wow.
geolocated transactions coming from Ohio.
Now, that was midnight to 1 or midnight to what?
12:01 to 1.
Okay.
Yes, or 1:01. I don't know if they did the exact 1:01, but it was 12:01 to 1 o'clock.
Yep.
So, great start for Ohio.
Yeah.
And it's just going to get better because they've got even more entities launching as the year's going to go on.
Sure, sure, absolutely.
A couple of benchmarks to hit. We've got Nevada, Virginia, and Colorado, all reported November numbers. The interesting thing with Nevada, Nevada reported a total gaming revenue. This is everything, sports betting, casino, okay. all that. $1.2 billion in total revenue for the month.
Okay.
Now, what they have here is with November's revenue, they have passed all of 2021's revenue for the year.
So wait.
They've okay. got one more month, and they've already beaten
oh, okay.
last
for the
year's
okay.
totals.
All right. Okay.
I always thought that was kind of interesting the way some of these numbers come out that way. And Nevada seems to be getting back everything it lost from the pandemic.
Sure, sure. I think as we move farther away from yes. the pandemic, you know, I think those numbers are going to get bigger and better. And
yep. They now have, right now, $13.5 billion.
Wow.
For year-to-date revenue, which is more than what they had all of last year.
Yeah.
11 months versus 12.
Yeah. Well, great. Good for them.
Yep. Two other states reported some interesting numbers for November, Virginia and Colorado. Actually, Virginia and Colorado hit sort of the same benchmark.
Okay.
Both Virginia and Colorado had their first back-to-back $500 million handle months.
Oh, okay.
So, very interesting number there. Virginia had a tax record of $7.78 million in November. That beat September's number of $7.3 million taxes,
okay.
monthly tax revenue. That's because they had that change in their law where they are no longer allowing the sports betting operators to deduct all the free bets and promos.
Okay. All
so
right.
we're going to see it grow even more.
So, hey,
I mean, this is a new record.
Better for the state.
December may show an even bigger record.
Sure.
So, you know, it's kind of interesting to see what's going on here. We have Colorado, very interesting number with regards to their betting handle in terms of basketball and pro football.
Yeah, yeah, very
NBA, interesting. NBA, this is the first NFL season where the NBA season beat the NFL. In the monthly handle
in,
for this
in
monthly
month. Handle?
In monthly
oh,
handle.
NBA beat, yes. beat the NFL in yes. monthly handle. Oh, well,
yep.
interesting. No.
Yeah, no. Hey, I guess it's because they suck.
The Denver Broncos. Yeah, I guess so.
I mean, I don't know. That's the only thing I can think of.
I know Russell Wilson's rubbing a lot of people the wrong way. I wonder if that affected the urge to bet on the Broncos. So, no, it was a very interesting stat for Colorado.
Virginia also became the 10th state to pass the $4 billion handle mark in year-to-date handle.
Okay.
And Colorado passed $9.5 billion year-to-date.
Okay.
I'm sorry, all-time handle. That's another benchmark for them. Table tennis.
We talk about Colorado sports betting, I think of table tennis because, Colorado and Oregon?
Oregon, yep.
They're the two top betting markets for table tennis, I would guess. So this month, where did table tennis fall in Colorado?
It was the eighth sport.
Okay.
Eighth top sport in terms of handle.
Okay.
It actually brought in just a little over $6 million in handle. 100% of it was online. There was no retail betting on table tennis. And I don't know if that's because that option's not available
in the books. Stream it there, I guess. So if you bet on table tennis, where would you watch it? It's only streamed. Yeah, I guess so.
Unless, I guess ESPN3. I know that site's still up and running. I don't know if it's...
What, the Ocho? I should put table tennis in the. I mean,
it technically still is.
Isn't it an Olympic sport or something like that? Or
well, hey,
I don't
even know. You know, it's one of those things where, again,
if you're going to bet on something, usually you want to watch it to see how you do.
I mean, it's not,
I just don't know where you watch table tennis.
It doesn't fall back into the realm of pickleball, dodgeball, slap fighting, or mini golf.
So
I think it's starting to gain some momentum, but still. And someone pointed out, and I can't remember who it was, because I want to give credit to it, because it was a very interesting comment. It's actually a good comment. Why ping pong table tennis is popular in Colorado. Mm-hmm. When Colorado launched, it was during the pandemic, and there weren't too many sports to bet on.
Okay. I can see that.
Ping pong was table. I want to say ping. It's table tennis.
Yeah.
I want to give it the proper name. Table tennis was the only thing running at the time.
I'm very curious. That term ping pong, is that insulting to table tennis players, or I'm sure they prefer table tennis? But I don't want to offend any players, and you know about calling it ping pong. I grew up; it was called ping pong. But I don't want to offend any table tennis players out there.
Well, I'm going to refer to it as table tennis just to be on the safe side, and then I'm going to go watch Balls of Fury again.
Yes, which is dodgeball.
Balls of Fury is the table tennis.
Oh, is it? Oh, yeah, that's right. Okay.
Christopher Walken and Dan Fogler.
Yeah, that's right. Yes, Why was I thinking dodgeball? Okay, no, yeah, it was ping pong.
It was ping pong, yep.
Yeah.
Christopher Walken, excellent in that movie.
Oh,
well, he's good in everything. So,
yeah.
But that was a good ping pong movie.
Okay.
Actually, I think it's the only ping pong movie.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah.
All right. Let's.
Why was I thinking dodgeball? What the hell was I thinking?
You had just mentioned the Ocho.
Oh, okay. That's why.
Which is probably why your mind was over on dodgeball.
I guess so.
Okay. Anyway, let's head on over to some deals. Today's deal segment, we've got a couple deals involving WagerScore. We've got IGT. We've got a couple acquisitions. And we're going to start off with WagerScore.
Yeah.
WagerScore, as everyone knows, is making a name for itself in the responsible gambling arena of the betting industry.
I just interviewed Bo Gray, the founder of WagerScore.
Very, very, very good interview.
Thank you.
Yes.
Full credit for that.
He was thank good. Anyway, WagerScore, right before the launch of Ohio sports betting, they announced a deal with the Cincinnati Bengals. They had mm-hmm. already done a deal in Tennessee with the Titans, NFL team Titans. Mm-hmm. The program they launched with Cincinnati is called Don't Fumble Your Finances.
Oh, okay.
And as part of the launch in Ohio with Cincinnati and also Betfred, they were working with Betfred as well with this.
Okay.
They were giving away to all new signups four tickets to the Ravens-Bengals game this past weekend.
Mm-hmm.
I believe it was the final game of the season because of what happened the previous week with the Cincinnati-Buffalo game.
Okay.
WagerScore is basically, it's a free app where you sign up and it gives you it monitors your sports betting expenses. It's almost like a credit score for your sports betting.
Mm-hmm.
Put it that way. That might be the best way to look at it. And the Cincinnati Bengals, as part of the deal, is providing WagerScore with all their gaming data to improve the functionality of the program itself.
That's great. Great.
And both WagerScore and the Bengals will be giving $100,000 to the Charles Oakley Foundation as well as part of the deal.
Great, great. Yeah, no, WagerScore.com is the website. Check them out. It's a very interesting site.
It's a very, very useful site for responsible gambling.
I know. It's great.
Yeah. IGT announced that they did a deal with Green Bear Gaming Development in Ohio, where they are launching as YouBet Ohio to distribute the IGT Play Sports platform in the state. They're going to be doing the, let me get this right, the IGT Play Sports Quick Bet kiosks throughout the state in restaurants and bars.
Okay.
And also they're going to be doing or distributing the IGT Play Sport pad in the coming months. The pad is actually a tablet.
Oh, wow. Okay.
If you ever, everyone's gone to, I think it's Buffalo Wild Wings or.
Sure.
And you see the tablet they
hand
out.
At the table, yeah. Okay.
It's going to be something like that, but it's for sports betting purposes.
Oh, okay.
So
I got to tell you, Ohio is going to be amazing in a couple of months. It's already amazing. And with the kiosk that's going to be around the state and the pad now you just talked about, I'm very curious. I know Kroger's is going to have kiosks. I want to see where they're placed, because if you want to increase sports betting, I mean, look, we've all been in a grocery store waiting in line and things like that.
Yep.
Can you imagine if there was a kiosk while you're waiting in line to get to the register? I mean, it'd be amazing.
You already have those machines for the lottery. You might as well have them for sports betting too. I mean, honestly, if you're going to bet on the lottery, you should be able to bet on sports
betting. I think it's great, but I'm not a kiosk guy.
No.
I mean, I just don't. I mean, if I have my phone,
I may try
the
pad if it makes it to New Jersey. I haven't seen it in New Jersey yet. It's around the United States and Canada.
Yeah. Okay.
But the tablet version of I haven't seen it yet.
I think I used a kiosk once, and it was in Parks Casino.
Yeah.
So usually, if and that was Pennsylvania, because all my apps are New Jersey, but I figured I'd give it a shot, and I tried it, and it was okay.
I have never used a kiosk. So.
Oh, yeah, no, I've used a kiosk once. Yep. That was it. So.
A couple acquisition notes to hit. Supergroup acquired Digital Gaming Corporation, which gives them access to 12 new markets in the country, the United States.
Okay.
Eight live markets are part of the deal. Arizona, Iowa, New Jersey, Pennsylvania, Virginia, Colorado, Indiana, and Ohio. So there's going to be more and more Supergroup platforms being launched that way.
Good.
That's one acquisition. We had another one. BetSperts announced the acquisition of Bleacher Nation, which that's their fourth transaction in 18 months. So they've been gobbling up different entities.
Okay.
Bleacher Nation, I thought this was interesting, began as just a blog for the covering the Chicago Cubs.
Huh.
It's grown since then.
Well, look,
it
has to start somewhere.
Exactly.
So, good.
Yep. And I thought this was kind of interesting because I like minor league baseball. U.S. Integrity announced a renewal of their partnership with the Northwoods League.
Oh, okay.
Which is a minor league league. And they've had major stars in their league, like Max Scherzer, Chris Sale, Brandon Crawford have all played in that league.
Yeah.
So they did an extension of their deal for Integrity Services.
Yeah. You know, great thing about minor league baseball is when, the big stars are doing their rehab things and, they're coming back from an injury. It used to be our local team, the Trenton Thunder, used to be a Yankees farm team. And Jeter was there, A-Rod was there getting back from an injury. I mean, where else can you see these stars up close? It's a great stadium. It's not a huge stadium, so you're really close to the players.
Well, actually, the Trenton Thunder started out as a Tigers minor league team.
Detroit Tigers.
Boston
Red Sox, where you saw a young Nomar Garciaparra
hit his first home run.
Oh, okay. You saw it?
I watched it.
Oh,
I was
my
in
God.
The stands and I watched it.
I didn't know.
He hit it out of the park.
Yeah, it's
right on the Delaware River.
Yeah, right on the Delaware River. Yeah.
You hit it out of the park.
Oh, wow. How close do you get to the river?
That I don't know because I was on the other side. Okay. I was on the other side of the wall. I didn't see where it landed, yeah. But it went out of the park.
It went from...
It was a massive shot.
Yeah, it went from Detroit, Boston, and then the New York Yankees, yep. And then I think it's independent now.
Yeah, pretty much all minor league teams are just about independent yep. because of what happened over COVID.
Yeah, yeah.
So that's it for the deal segment. Let's head on over to some industry updates.
You know what I'm saying? For everybody. Game starts at 20, bet slip is empty. I gotta call KG.
KG, what up?
I got nothing for you, Fox.
Ah, come on.
What you got, huh?
It is spa day, Jamie. You don't interrupt spa day.
Ah, okay.
Gressy, what's up?
I need some tips.
Jamie, you want a tip?
Yeah.
Oh.
Come on, somebody. Jalen, what's up, man?
You want a tip?
Yeah, you really want a tip?
I really need some tips.
Don't call somebody on live TV, Jamie Foxx.
Well, you like asked. Have other friends anyway.
Marshawn, Barry, holla.
Jamie Foxx. Like, what's up with it, Foxx?
Listen, I need some tips.
I'm like LA.
LA?
No, Dallas.
Dallas?
Dallas? We gotta get to Miami.
How about Detroit?
Nah, Barry over there.
You know, I'm gonna call y'all right now. Vanessa, mm-hmm. I need your help.
I got a tip for you. Always go with your gut.
I like that. Going with my gut.
Let's go with our gut!
Couple industry updates to talk about. We've got a very unique licensee that was granted a sports betting license at the end of the year in Ohio. And I thought, when I saw this, I thought it had to be something different. But Phantom Fireworks was granted a Type B sports betting provider license, wow. Which means they're going to be opening a retail sports book.
Okay.
They announced that they're going to be working with the United States Hockey League's Youngstown Phantoms.
Oh, okay.
They're going to actually have a retail book in the Covelli Center. That's where the Phantoms play their home games.
Is there a Phantom Fireworks in Pennsylvania?
That's where they're headquartered. They're Youngstown, Ohio centered, but they have them in Jersey. They have them in Pennsylvania.
Well, they got to do Jersey because I think it's... Yeah. Well, I think... I don't know if you can sell them. I don't even know.
They're all.
I don't know the latest in firework law.
Yeah, so. I'm not a fireworks attorney.
I gotta tell you,
I don't know.
Around 4th of July in New Jersey, you start seeing the billboards, and there's a big one right across the Delaware River in Pennsylvania.
Yeah, right on Route 1, I think. As a matter of fact,
I don't even know. It's in Pennsylvania. I'm not
or 95, sure. 95,
it's,
something
it's
like
in
that.
Pennsylvania. Yeah. I'm not even sure. So,
yeah. But I always see Phantom Fireworks billboards around that time, and also New Year's too.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, so both those times of the year. But this is for a retail book, and it's going to be inside the Covelli Center and should be up and running by March Madness, they say.
Oh, okay.
So we're going to be seeing the Phantom Fireworks Sportsbook somewhere.
Okay.
I don't know if it's going to be branded Phantom Fireworks Sportsbook or however they're going to be doing it, but they're going to be launching it in conjunction with the Phantoms. It makes sense.
Phantoms. Let me. Opening night of that, will there be a firework display? There almost.
I would hope
be.
So. I would hope
there
so.
There would have to
I
be.
I would hope
I mean,
so.
Jeez.
Going over to Massachusetts, which has been going through their application hearings. Last week, they had started the Fanatics application process hearing, mm-hmm. And a couple of news and notes came out of that. One was that the Fanatics as a company is on track to launch its betting and gaming business the first quarter of 2023. Mm-hmm. Massachusetts may be their first location to launch. If they get approval at the time we're taping this, there was no vote they got pushed off to next week. But what came out of it was kind of interesting was that they are going to be using the Imelco platform, which they've been quietly keeping under wraps.
Okay.
They haven't really announced it until they actually just disclosed it in this application process. Mm-hmm. It raised a whole bunch of questions. It was like one of those secret that everybody knows, but still considered a secret.
Yeah.
They actually, when they were doing their, they had to do a demonstration of their platform for the Gaming Commission.
Didn't they do that behind closed doors?
They did it during an executive session.
Yes, okay. Yes. So, which means they, in private.
Private. Yeah. And I understand that. I mean, sure, they didn't want to disclose what they were doing.
You know, there's
the
a lot of trade secrets and a lot of intellectual property involved in these online things. So, yeah, it makes sense.
And the Imelco platform is the same platform that was used by Fubo Sportsbook, PlayUp, FoxBet. And also, it's being used by Hard Rock in their four states that they're live in.
Okay.
So it's not a widely used platform, if you want to put that, because one's out with Fubo.
Yeah.
PlayUp is for sale. FoxBet, I don't know too many people who use it.
It's still active.
It's an active platform, you know.
There's just, in New Jersey, it's too many. I'd blow up my phone if I put them all on.
I think there's now too many in Pennsylvania. There's now too many Ohio.
I mean, there's just too many for my phone to be on. So
we'll see exactly where Fanatics goes with all of this. It'll be interesting to see Bet Fanatics for the first time, wherever it launches.
Yeah.
But again, they're still going through their application process with the state of Massachusetts. I don't know if they're going to be getting it. I mean, the way they were hammering them during the application
hearing. I think they'll get it. I mean, certainly, though.
There were questions. They claimed there was, the gaming commissioners said that there are some deficiencies in their application. They've supplied some of the information. We'll see where it goes.
Yeah, but I'm sure they'll get all worked out.
Yeah, it'll be taken care of at some point.
But Barstool was allowed. They gave the okay to Barstool, right?
They got a conditional one. We'll talk about that more in the legislative section.
Oh, okay.
So we got that coming up. And last but not least, for the industry updates segment, we've got a brand new president in Atlantic City.
Yeah, yeah.
George Goldoff was named president of Hard Rock Hotel Atlantic City.
Yeah.
It's going to be effective January 30th, and he's still got to go through regulatory approval for the switchover.
Sure.
Goldoff was actually over at Hard Rock Cincinnati.
Oh, okay.
So he's leaving one launching casino to go to a, you know.
I gotta tell you,
that's a sports betting launching casino, I should say.
I know. Hard Rock is one of my favorite places in Atlantic City. It's just absolutely beautiful there. We were at a conference there.
East Coast Gaming.
And also the esports thing, Landel.
Was there in Esports Gaming Congress. It's a great location.
Oh, yeah. I always take a video of the escalator. They have the best escalator in Atlantic City.
Yep.
So it's a big round thing with, I don't even know if that's video. I guess it's
a video.
Video.
Wall.
It's a big video wall that you go down, and it's really fun.
I think the phrasing is LED video wall, like what they have in the sports books.
Let me tell you something. They have a deceptively large sports book there. You know, when you look down the hall, it says, "Oh, it's like a front thing," but when you walk down there, I mean, it goes back a little way. So it's a very good sports book, too.
I was actually surprised because I had always just walked by thinking it was just a counter.
Yeah, I thought it was just a front there. But when you walk there, there's another kind of room and another space to it.
It's actually very comfortable.
It is. It's very good.
So if you get a chance, take a look at that Hard Rock sports book. Very, very nice job on their part.
Yeah, it's very close to the entrance to the boardwalk, too.
So. Let's finish up with some legislative roundups. Let's start off by talking Colorado.
Okay.
We just went through their numbers at the top of the show, and we also talked about Virginia setting a tax record for the month regarding the change in the policy where they were getting rid of the promo deductions.
Mm-hmm.
Colorado is going to have the same thing. They just, a law went into effect at the beginning of this year where the promos and free bets are no longer going to be deducted.
Okay.
So they're,
it's more money for the state.
That's exactly the reason. They're anticipating the $12.4 million they got last fiscal year to double to about $24
million. A bigger chunk of that table tennis money.
Yes. Well, that table tennis money brings in a lot of money. So $6 million is nothing to sneeze at.
No.
But again, you know, it I understand it, and I think it's the right move. I know some, when states are enacting legislation now, they actually have sliding scales for these deductions. Mm-hmm. And a lot of the states that have already been up and running are now changing their legislation to reflect the removal of these deductions.
Sure.
Because
they see how much more tax money these other states are getting by taking away that deduction.
Right, and a lot of times the sports books and the sports book operators were using the promos and the free bets and the deductions to get around paying taxes.
Yeah, yeah.
And, you know, that's a lot of the sports betting legislation at the time when it was launched were still new to all this. And I think they're now getting a little more savvy when they draft this legislation.
Sure, sure.
And it shows the maturity of a market, too, when you actually have legislators who actually understand the business a lot more than when they did the first time around.
Yeah, yeah.
So it's great to see that for the state. Not good for the operators in some cases.
Right? So,
we'll see exactly where
don't
it
cry
goes.
For the sports books. They're making money.
No. So, but again, Colorado will see an increase in their tax revenue. Their tax numbers should reflect that pretty soon. Got a couple things coming out of Massachusetts and Ohio, and I'm tying them together because a lot of the people being affected in Ohio by some of the Gaming Control Commission fines there are actually up for licenses or have been given temporary licenses in Massachusetts. Ohio Casino Control Commission, and this is I don't know if this is going to get worse or get better in Ohio for the operators, but the Ohio Casino Control Commission has been levying fines after fines after fines against the operators for violating the advertising policies.
Okay.
We had three just recently. We had $150,000 levied against, let me get the list right, we have BetMGM, Caesars, and DraftKings.
Okay.
DraftKings, this is the second one.
All right.
DraftKings got nailed with a $350,000 fine not too long ago for targeting underage gamblers in their advertising.
Well, claiming they targeted. I'm sure they weren't targeting underage gamblers.
Well, that's what the charge was.
Yeah.
Yeah. And they're going to be doing hearings. Ohio's
a very new market. When I say very new market, as we're sitting here, it's a couple days old. So, I mean, everyone's getting their legs under them, and they're trying to figure out the parameters of everything. So you're going to have this.
Yeah. Well, these fines do affect the other states.
Okay.
And, you know, I don't know what's going on with DraftKings in terms of the two fines. I mean, they were given the chance to appeal the first one. I don't know if, now that they have a second one, I don't know what the Casino Control Commission is going to be doing.
Okay.
I mean, you also still have the Barstool one that they got nailed with for the Toledo University situation.
Okay.
And Barstool.
Are these in public? Because I'd love to see these things. I know Massachusetts, when you talk about Massachusetts, they have a YouTube page.
I wonder, does
Ohio have a YouTube page that I can watch this?
I know they're open to the public in terms of you can actually go and sit there. And,
okay. All right.
I don't know exactly if they're the same way as Mass Gaming Commission.
Yeah.
But if they are, great. Go take a look at them. But again, it's one of those things where when Barstool got nailed for that Toledo University incident in Ohio, the Mass Gaming Commission went right after Barstool in the application hearing.
Okay.
And they're still doing it because they got the temporary license from the Gaming Commission. And that was with that fine hanging over their heads in Ohio. They've got to deal with investigations, constant investigations, suitability investigations in Massachusetts now because of that, even though they got the temporary license.
All right.
And, you know, Penn has already said that they're going to pay the fine for that one back in Toledo.
Oh, Ohio?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. So we'll see what's going on with that. Again, we've got all these books given temporary licenses, got other books coming in for their application hearings. Whether or not the Gaming Commission in Massachusetts is going to take the lead from the Ohio Gaming Commission and start being, I don't want to say the word hard asses, but are going to be very difficult and strict in enforcing the fines. But we'll see what happens there.
Well, everything. Like I said, it's new for a lot of places. Yeah. So, you know, they're just trying to find the parameters they can work in.
Yeah. And again, we got Massachusetts launching their retail at the end of the year. The end of the month here, January 31st.
Yeah.
So we're going to have Ohio and Massachusetts bookending everything. Massachusetts seems to be taking note of what's going on in Ohio with the violations. So it's going to be interesting to see the trickle-down effect,
yeah,
not just for Massachusetts, but for some of the other states that are coming online this year as well.
Okay.
So it's just something to keep an eye on. That's it for this week's Turnpike Sports Book Report. If you've been watching us on TV, the ticker's been going by, showing you other news stories we didn't have a chance to cover in our half hour. Also, the print version will be up on the blog, turnpikesports.us. Click on the blog button, it'll be there. info@turnpikesportsradio.com is the email address to send all the PR and press releases and company releases to. And just enjoy your week, everybody, and we'll be back next week with a new episode.
And that'll do it for us this week. We'll see you next time on the Turnpike.